Why?
Take her out here. Well, I got something a bit more special today. I'm going to expand some of the tools that we have available in the maker shop. And the first one of the tools that I'm going to add now is the bench pillar drill. And we'll see what this looks like. This is a kind of a cheapo thing. It comes from the branding is Parkside, and it comes from a store chain called Lidl, which is rather common in Europe. Exists in most European countries, and they use these as like these. They use tools as a kind of a way to get more customers to come to the store to buy other things. So they don't actually stock this very often. So now when it turned up, I bought it, and usually they have these types of tools for around 100 US. Depending on what they are. So, let's have a look and see what we can find. See how the camera's picking stuff up. Okay, what is this? This is quite well packed. Give you a better picture of it. So, there's some instructions. Open that first. Certificates of some kind. Well, we don't need those. Some kind of a assembly guide here. I didn't open this in advance, so there does not seem to be any step-by-step guide how to put this together. That's safety instructions. Okay. This is in Swedish, but it's fully text. There are no drawings, which is a bit sad. Okay, maybe it's very easy to put together or something. I think we take the parts out first. Thank you. section for the drill. This is probably the laser unit. Wow, this is heavy. Aha, it's the chuck. A bit oily, actually, this whole thing. Yuck. Oh, let's get some paper here. I suppose oily means that it's well protected. Ship that. Okay. All right, now we have the base unit. Some nice big motor on. Whoa, it's got a lot of oil. That's the pedestal. And we just have to check this. Anything else in the box? Oh, the box is empty. Okay, so let's see now. Looking at the base unit. Power cable. Okay, I'll take the one that start with the pedestal, I suppose. Didn't think there would be so much oil on this. This is probably good that it's protected. Batteries for the laser. These will be handles. Understand what those are. Should be 3 volts for this thing, I'm assuming. And they just screw in there. Ah, fantastic. So, okay. Start that. And the only tool included is this one. Even though it really doesn't, I have not read the instructions exactly what order things go together, but I could assume that one could actually quite safely argue that this one should go first. It's symmetrical, so it shouldn't matter which way around it goes. Too big, so let's see. Trying to see what kind of order they have here. 15, 16, 17. Oh, that's cool. Yeah. What the? I don't understand their ordering of the. They do have a breakdown picture, so that's pretty much almost. I'll have to get my sockets. There we go. Is that so? So my basic socket set. Oh, feed them in. Looks like there were only 2 bolts. I think I took this paper. It's actually strange that it only comes with 2 bolts. I think I'm gonna add some bolts myself. I have so few bolts. Anyway, so the way this is gonna go, it's gonna go like that. And then there's gonna be a washer there. And then the spring washer. And then the nut. Like that. And then it's going to be dropped through. I'll just hand tighten it from that. Well, as I said, I'll probably get some more bolts. Not two more of the same. Probably wanted to save money, but not including. The price you pay for not buying the professional stuff. Professional stuff always costs crap loads more. Okay, so sleeve and tightened. Put that in place. So now we have to put the motor unit, and since this is not screwed to the table, I'm not sure it's going to balance, so we're going to have to be a bit careful if it actually decides it's going to fall over. But anyway, let's see if we actually do this. God, this is all full of oil. Adjust the camera. There's not enough to. Let's see now. There we go. I have to have it like that, but it seems to stay there. Seems to be still. I don't think one needs to be directly afraid that it's gonna fall off. This tool that came with it, it's on the right side, so it actually has two screws, locking screws. So one's there. I should actually tighten it with. Just try and get it straight, I suppose. I wonder how one can see that. Try and hide it as possible. Best as possible, I suppose. And adjust it better later, I suppose. And now it's important to get this false and into place. Feels sturdy enough for the amateur work that I'm going to be putting this thing to. That's good enough for preliminary. I wonder if I'm missing one tool. It says that there should be a spanner to tighten these on. So, to pause a bit to find my own tool. So I could actually check the package and doesn't seem to be anything with this. So we need to just tighten the knobs on. So we put, see now if I can get a good picture. Put it on there. And then we just tighten down the knob. And do it with all three of them. That would be a good angle, I hope. And then we're supposed to screw these in here. Not too much, this is aluminium, so I would not suggest a very hard handle. Look, it works. I think you can see it in the picture. What's next? Laser. Okay, we should install the laser mechanism. Okay, it's just needs to, but then I think we need to. Okay, how do you get this open to put the batteries on? It's the strangest mechanism. So what you need to do is you're going to need to, let's see, you need to, that one will be like that, and it has a little peg there. What you need to do is you need to move it up, and then you can pull the unit open like that. Seems to work. Let's see. Okay. Ah, it's got two laser lights that are coming out from there and there. I don't know how that's going to work. We'll see. In practice, and then it's supposed to be screwed in with this screw. I need to get a screwdriver. Put that. Maybe use the small one. Does not seem to want to come in. Bigger screwdriver. The threads aren't very good on this one. It's better. So I think I got it eased up a bit. Probably just not a very good fit. Oy! So, is the laser in place? I'm going to switch it on. Well, that seems to work alright. Okay, what's left now? Well, I'm going to have to align that better. Seems to be very awful. Look, let me put it together first. Loosen the screws and line it later. And then let's just tighten the screw on the side here. Be done. I suppose that comes up like that. We have the chuck. I wonder if I can reposition camera a bit down. Let's see. Something like that. Thank you. Okay, now I'm supposed to put this in place and then hit it with a plastic hammer. And I do have a plastic hammer, but I actually don't know where it is. So what I will do now is I will place it in its place. Like that. And then I will come back to it and knock it a few times with the plastic hammer. I don't know if I'll make a video about it. Or continue the video about it. So anyway, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to stop the video here, and then I'm going to do some alignment adjustments and stuff and set it up for drilling. And then I do a couple of drilling demos. But first I need to find out where I put my plastic hammer. So anyway, back soon on video time. See, found the plastic hammer. So, or rubber hammer. Put this on. Then I want you to knock it a few times. So, that should do it. So, that's now on. Straighten this out a bit more because I don't think I got this very straight. So I had an idea of using this straight edge against the body. Easier to do it on the other side. Distance to the body at a straight angle from the pedestal, and we'll see where we end up. It's so strange because it looks like it's off center, but actually that's very little off center. One could maybe argue a few millimeters. Don't know if it's even worth adjusting. Six centimeters from the basis with the long straight edge. But I must say it was very close. I don't know why my eye is saying that it's... could be my glasses. That's what's causing that. I think that it's looking more crooked than it's actually is. And it's not that mission critical, really. that. And then this will be center up. So that will be the next step, is to find something to drill. And as I said, I'm using this more for hobbyist purposes, so I'm happy if it drills like maximum 4mm mild steel with some level of success. I think I will be happy. So I'm not really expecting miracles out of this thing. Mostly I'll be dealing with aluminium, I would assume, copper. It's so strange, it still looks like it's not straight, even if it is. It's probably my glasses on the top. Oh, I think I'm just going to leave it. So anyway, that's the assembly process then. I will get things, something to drill, and then we can test to. Actually, we could try and start it at least, just to see that it actually turns. Blow a fuse or something. Need to open up the whole extension lead. Try and see if it turns. Well, it's be interesting to see how this works when we get the drill on. It's okay, Charles, my four-legged helper here, got a bit upset, he was sleeping, and then we put the machine on. I have to do some, but then of course this whole table is very shaky, so I'm thinking I'm probably seeing shakiness in the whole machine. So we'll see how, because this spindle feels relatively, a little. Say if there's sideways or not. I don't think there's that much sideways motion. It's a cheap thing. But anyway, next stuff will be to find something to drill. So let's see if we can drill something. drill okay. I think it was wandering a little bit over. Gonna have to get more experience with using this, I think. Something moved. I don't know what. It was quite a lot. I have to probably put in pilot holes, I thought. But anyway, you expect buying some of the cheapest stuff one can get on the market. But I think that one can probably improve on it. And I don't, not really 100% sure if my drill bit is that perfect either. I couldn't find any steel to drill, so I'll have to wait for some other day. Actually, I don't do much in steel. It's mainly plastic and aluminium that I work with for the hobby stuff that I do. No, but I think this will do it. I'll just get a little bit more experience with this and check and see if I can find out why that did not. Chuck seems to move a bit in this direction, but not in this direction. That's a bit strange. Can also run this table the other way around, I suppose. But anyway, we shall see. It's all up and running at least. It's just to start using it and learning what its limitations are. And then I suppose the one should adjust the laser. Okay, that's just two lines that one crosses, I think. That doesn't seem to move. This one. Could be that one of the lines is permanently across. Gonna have to do a bit of figuring out with that. So I don't really know how I would mark, because it says that the X is here. And this doesn't seem to move when I adjust this. Strange. I might come back with an update a little bit later after I've got some more experience of using it and add some more comments. Anyway, that was that video for now. If you enjoyed it, think about subscribing. And if you like the video, press the like button and continue with producing more videos. I know. Also reviewing tools that I intend to use. Anyway, yep. See you in the next one.